Yeah, here they come. Adam. And it's supposed to have a thing to the right.
You see this some trees pop up eventually. Because you need the front of this.
TC Adam? Where is he?
Maybe that's it.
I can't tell. Halfway away.
See right there?
With his hair. Oh, nice. Look at the drone. See it up there? Is that Anna? He's got like burgundy pants on. Oh my god, I got cold chills. Where? Walking this way? He's got a black mask. Yeah, you know the one he wears? There's a lot of kids, so we're gonna see. Where's Anna on? Where's Anna on? Looking for Adam. Did you? What happened?
She's walking right there by herself. Black shoes.
Oh.
Now she's looking for
him. Okay. Did you find Adam?
No, I didn't see him. I was looking.
He's probably in the back.
Oh, he's right there.
Where?
Look.
Where?
Here. I think it's him. I can't tell.
Oh, Adam! Adam's right over there.
I told you that was him.
Where's Haley? Let's call Haley.
I'm trying to see where Haley's going on, Mr. Charlie.
Adam's the 1, 2, 3, 4, the fifth row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the sixth kid. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No, the sixth row, the sixth kid.
Where's Haley go?
Where's Haley?
Just
yeah. Adam! He hears us.
I know. Was this
Adam!
The West Coast pop.
He's just like an army dude. Just Adam! Oh, Adam's over there. Is that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 row, the sixth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the sixth kid.
Okay.
Where's your daughter?
Shorter one. There's the lady in the black. And he's walking right past her.
Oh, I missed her.
She's walking this way.
Oh, wait.
you're the last one that was walking this way.
What row? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. The 10th one? Oh, I see her. Haley! She needs to look this way. She's not looking at me. They don't listen to us. They don't listen to us. Adam! The sixth one. 1, 2, 3, 4. The sixth one, the sixth. You see him? He turned.
Is that him with the black shirt looking all over?
Adam's looking dead straight that way. He's the sixth row, the sixth kid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then the sixth one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The sixth one. Okay. Yeah. Adam!
Please continue standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem sung by the Horlick High School Chorale under the direction of Mr. Brian Plain. We ask that you sing along. Well, Catherine Sizing, salutatorian, please come forward. And the Horlick High School Chorale, please take your places.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
As we start out our ceremony today, I would like to congratulate and dedicate this ceremony to Mr. Mark Hansen, who is retiring at the end of this year. So let's give a round of applause to Mr. Hansen. And also Mrs. Sharon Downey, who is an educational assistant in our library. Good afternoon and welcome to the Academies of Racine Horlick 2021 93rd Commencement Ceremony. On behalf of the administration, I would like to introduce to you and welcome our special guests. Guests, please stand when I call your name. Executive Director of Employee Relations, Ms. Carrie Hanstead. School Board members, School Board President, Mr. Brian O'Connell. School Board Vice President, Mr. Matthew Hanser. School Board Member, Ms. Amy Simbalnik. And School Board Member, Ms. Julie McKenna.
Superintendent Dr. Eric Galyon, who could not be with us this evening, extends his heartfelt congratulations to each and every one of our graduates and wishes you the best of luck in all your future endeavors. I wish to thank him for all his support. It is my great pleasure and honor to address our graduates and our guests. I am pleased to announce that the class of 2021 has earned over $2 million in scholarships.
Nice, yeah.
Congratulations, seniors, on a job well done. You have all worked so hard and come so far to reach this milestone under some very trying circumstances. So I know that this is a big day for all of you and your families, and for everyone at the Academies of Racine William Horlick High School who supported you on this journey. Class of 2021, today is your day. As this ceremony closes and you turn your tassels from right to left, you will begin a new adventure. As I look out amongst you, I see the faces of eager young men and women ready to begin the next chapter of their lives. I also think of those freshman faces as you came into Horlick, not knowing what the next 4 years had in store. Making your mark on the world is hard. It takes patience. It takes commitment. It comes with plenty of setbacks and plenty of failures. But whenever you hear those voices that say you can't make a difference, whenever someone tells you to set your sights lower, prove them wrong. What you have to realize, though, is that everyone is scared. What's going to set you apart is how you can deal with that fear, how you can power through it. And if you have the relentless determination, fortitude, and sheer tenacity to transform all of that nervous energy and anxiety into courage. Courage to try, courage to take risks, and courage to face failure. Class of 2021, as you go forward from this moment on, I would like you to make a point of reaching out to people whose beliefs and values differ from your own. I would like you to listen to them, truly listen, and try to understand them and find that common ground. We have no idea what the future holds, and that's okay. Don't think about what you want to do. Think about why you want to do it, and the rest will figure itself out. Believe it or not, I love what I do. It's a calling, a passion, and a lot of hard work. People always ask me, what is the best part of your job?
Thank you.
And I say it's you, the students.
30. Same. Congratulations.
You are the purpose and the reason I do what I do. You are a diverse group of students with many talents and accomplishments. When you are deciding on next steps, next jobs, next careers, further education, you should rather find the purpose than a job or a career. Purpose crosses disciplines. Purpose is an essential element of you. Your parents, your family members, and friends have been your support system throughout your school career and will continue to be here for you throughout your life. Never forget that. I do have one last piece of advice that I always like to offer to you. Make sure you stay on your parents' wireless plans as long as you possibly can, because those are expensive. So if they'll carry you through adulthood, hang on. That being said, I have been fortunate to have shared these last 4 years with you. the ups, the downs, the historic pandemic, social distancing, lockdowns, remote learning, face masks, and the phrase, you are on mute. But we made it through, and you can make it through this. If you can make it through this, you can persevere and make it through anything. I want to thank you personally, each and every one of you, for the privilege and honor to have served you as your directing principal. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2021.
Yeah. Adam!
I would once again ask the Horlick Chorale to come forward. They will be singing Stand By Me.
That's not Adam, is it? Or are you saying Adam to someone else? Wait.
It's not the guy who's looking. Look, the row behind him.
What? That's who I thought was Adam.
Yeah, he's him.
It's Adam.
It's not Adam.
Maybe it's not him.
No, Adam didn't get a haircut. Where's my baby? Oh my God, I lost him. Well, the only way I'll find out is when he's walking up there. No, it's not there. I thought it was, it wasn't.
Horlick Chorale.
That's not him.
Yeah, no, I'm realizing it. It's great. Yo, that's a random kid.
He was looking all crazy.
At this time, I would like to present to you the class of 2021 salutatorian, Catherine Zizek. Katie has earned a grade point average of 3.925.
Wow. That is it.
And now it gives me great pleasure.
You can see the burgundy pants on you.
To present Elizabeth Hanstead and Anthony Pitroff as the class of 2021 co-valedictorians. Both students have earned a 4.0 grade point average for all 4 years. Will Lizzie please come forward to accept her medal?
Yeah.
Will Tony please come forward to accept his medal? As co-valedictorians of the class of 2021, Elizabeth and Tony will present farewell addresses to their fellow classmates. Lizzie, please come forward.
Hello and good evening to the graduating class of 2021. I have been in a boot or on crutches at some point in each of the last 4 years, so I thought it was only appropriate that I come dressed like this. But thank you, Ms. Atman, for the introduction. As she said, my name is Elizabeth Hanstead, also known as Lizzie, Smiley, or Ellie, if you were in any of the classes where I didn't know if I should correct the teacher on my name or not. A couple of weeks ago, Ms. Atman emailed me, inviting me to prepare a speech as a co-valedictorian. Considering I was the person who free-willingly danced on top of the tables before the ACT, I understand if this is a surprise to anyone. Yes, please pray for us all. Nevertheless, I took this task very seriously and wrote a speech similar to a highly important paper. So, last night at 11, I pulled up a Google Doc, drank my third Dunkin' of the day, scrolled through TikTok, had a mental breakdown
of
procrastinating, and suddenly started doing TikTok dances, so renegade. I then emailed Ms. Atman requesting that graduation be rescheduled. Considering we are all here today, you can guess her response. Finally, at 3 a.m., I got to writing a reflection of the last 4 years and determined that this is probably the best time management I've ever had for a project. In all seriousness, it is a true honor to give this speech today in front of such an incredible class and amazing friends. Graduates, you should be very proud of everything that you have done to get to this moment. The countless hours of studying, the sleepless nights trying to get homework done, and the endless papers written, all while surviving a global pandemic, have led to this very moment. When we first walked through the doors our freshman year, we had no idea what the future held. We quickly found out what it meant to be true freshmen and could not wait for the day that we could tell our fellow upperclassmen friends that we in fact did not have freshman 3-1 lunch, but we actually had 3-2 or 3-3 lunch. As soon as we hit that point, our sophomore selves embraced the fact that we were now not the youngest in the school and some could actually drive. It was painstakingly obvious who could drive and who couldn't, as our lanyards would often signify. Then junior year hit, which many, even in a normal year, would consider the most difficult. Between preparing for the ACT and trying to plan for life after high school, we discovered the miracles of not only caffeine, but also the internet. However, it all changed March 13th. Though we had no idea what would happen next, we were patient, flexible, and attempted to adapt to the new remote academic environment. However, as our junior year came to an end, we paused, swallowed hard, and hoped we would experience at least some benefits of being a senior. We understood that we had to adapt. So, also we know that this was not the senior year we planned. I mean, look, we're not even graduating at Horlick. But if there's one thing this year has taught us, it's the importance of perspective and that things could always be worse. For instance, we could have been graduating at Park today. That's how you know we would have hit an all-time low.
That's so wrong.
Our high school experience, especially with COVID, has illustrated our strength and resilience. Rather than surrendering to the negativity found around us, we instead found a way to make positive things happen.
That is him literally scratching.
Graduates, you are the reason why it makes everyone proud to say that they are a rebel. Families, grandparents, siblings, you have tirelessly cared for and guided us. You are one of the most significant reasons why we are here today. Whether our past take us to college, the military, or the work or dream careers, you have every reason to be proud. As this may be many people's first time attending a high school graduation, it is truly amazing knowing that the person you spent all night trying to add 2 + 2 together is sitting here today experiencing one of their greatest lifetime achievements with you by their side. And to the faculty at Horlick High School, it isn't easy to say how happy we are to have such a great, dedicated group of people committed to us. You work tirelessly to provide each of us with a solid foundation for a successful future. You set high expectations, moreover you patiently guided us, clearing the path for us to travel. The lessons we learned from you are remarkable and should be embraced every day. Horlick staff, you may not know this now, but you inspired our future doctors, future bestsellers, and of course, our future famous YouTube stars. So just wait for that. Now graduates, as we reflect on the hard work that we have done to get to this point, it is also important that we remember the endless possibilities that lie ahead. I believe that life, the beauty in life, lies in the fact that we have the ability to make choices. It is said that life is 10% what happens to you, 90% how you react. Now, as we move into the adult world, we get to choose how we view the days ahead. I cannot guarantee that things will happen for a reason, but I can assure you that things will happen. And when they do, just remember to embrace the moment you're in, no matter how hard or easy or sad or happy it is. Always be good to yourself. Be grateful and gentle to those on your path, because whatever you do in the days ahead, know that if you work hard and be kind, amazing things will happen to you. You never know just how far a smile can take you. After spending these 4 years with such a resilient and inspiring class, I do not doubt knowing that each of you will choose to do great things. Fellow classmates, our time together has been an absolute blessing, and I consider myself one of the luckiest people to be graduating among such an incredible class. The tears, the laughs, and pure joy shared throughout these years are a gift that just keep on giving. As a ceremony marks an end to a journey and beginning to anew, I think Winnie the Pooh best describes my thoughts today when he says, "How lucky I am to have something so hard to say goodbye to." Thank you and congratulations, class of 2021.
That was good.
For those inspiring words. I would like to invite Tony Pitroff up to the podium for his speech.
Good evening. I'm Tony Pitroff, and along with Lizzie, I'm one of the co-valedictorians of our class. It truly is an honor to have that title and to be able to speak for all of you here tonight. And hey, this is about to be the most any of you have ever heard me talk, so here we go. First, On behalf of the entire class, I want to thank some of the people who have helped us get to this point and graduate. To all of our teachers, counselors, administrators, coaches, and all Horlick staff, thank you. To our families, thank you to all the parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, and any other family members who have helped us along the way. And it's because of those we've just thanked that we're all here tonight, celebrating the Horlick class of 2021. Now, during our time at Horlick, we've had a lot of fun, memorable, good times. We got yelled at by Mr. Wendt during freshman lunch. We got to see our theater department put on Shrek and Beauty and the Beast. And we watched our individual athletes, volleyball, esports, cheer, and soccer teams go to state. We've also learned a lot during these 4 years. We learned how to pass the PACER test without really trying. We learned that we should always take our hoods off in the hallways. And in Spanish class, many of us learned the South American capital song, taught to us by one of our favorite Spanish teachers. But really, we learned how to manage ourselves, our time, our stress, and we became young adults.
Hello.
But along with these great memories, we've also faced a lot of challenges. We had the common issues of high schoolers, balancing our academics, jobs, activities, and social lives. But along with these normal obstacles, we also had to deal with COVID, which led to a whole brand new set of challenges. Like, how do we learn virtually? How do we stay connected with the people we no longer see every day? What do we do during a toilet paper shortage? Are we prepared for what will come next?
That's terrible.
But by overcoming these challenges, the class of 2021 has learned lessons and developed skills that we wouldn't have in any other year. The transition to virtual school has shown us all the importance of adaptability. The lack of in-person interaction has shown us the importance of having strong relationships with others. And the sudden cancellation of our last school year has taught us the importance of valuing the present moment and not taking any of our time for granted. Hopefully, going forward, these problems will be behind us, and the question or challenge for our class will be determining how we can use these newfound skills to benefit ourselves and our communities going forward. So, let's take these lessons, these skills, and everything we've learned during our time at Horlick, and use them to become the best people we can be. Finally, I just want to say congratulations to everybody in the Horlick class of 2021. And whether you're joining the workforce, entering the military, or going to college, I wish you good luck, and I know that you will all accomplish great things. Thank you.
That was good.
Thank you, Tony. At this time, we ask our senior band members, please make your way to the performance area. The Horlick Symphony Orchestra, directed by Jacob Myers, will entertain us with Star Wars Medley.
That's not Adam. That's not him. There's a taller kid.
Which one are you talking
about? The one that's turning inside and looking backwards.
The one in the row in front of me.
Oh, there's my baby. So I've been looking at the wrong kid all this time.
Is someone else?
Oh, yeah. Let's see. It's the sixth one. And the sixth row, sixth one. He's busy talking.
Thank you.
God. I know.
Thank you, Mr. Myers, and the Symphony Orchestra. At this time, I would ask Racine Unified School Board President, Mr. Brian O'Connell, to please join me at the podium for the presentation of the class of 2021. Graduates, please stand.
Yeah!
Mr. Brian,
I want to stand with them.
For me, as a representative of the staff and administration of the Academies of Racine William Horlick High School, to present to you the class of 2021.
I'm ready to scream.
I am proud to certify as a directing principal of the Academies of Racine William Horlick High School that each of the students standing before you and as graduates have completed all of the requirements for graduation as established and set forth by the state of Wisconsin and the Board of Education of the Racine Unified School District. Therefore, I ask that you confer this diploma from William Horlick High School to each of these deserving students on this day, June 3rd, 2021. Mr. O'Connell, please address our students.
Yes, get started.
As the school board president and representative of the entire Racine Unified School District and the Board of Education, at the recommendation of the directing principal, Angela Reese Atman, I confer upon each of you this diploma from the Academies of Racine William Horlick High School this third day of June 2021. Congratulations.
Graduates, please be seated. Thank you, Mr. O'Connell, and we appreciate your confirmation of our graduates. We will now begin the presentation of individual diplomas.
Yes.
Students, you will be approaching the stage by rows. Students, you have your name cards that you filled out. Please hand your card to the reader, which will be your counselor.
What?
Does it go to like 10 or 11?
12. Will the first full row please stand?
What do you mean?
Stand?
Oh no, I meant like, maybe it's like 1 in the morning or something.
Oh, I think 1 more hour. Okay. As soon as they're done, we're done. Yeah. Well, isn't he supposed to take a picture of each one? Oh, they have to go through here. Where's Carly sit on?
Students, please wait for the adult at the end of the row to cue you to stand. Guests, I know this is hard, but we ask that you hold all of your applause until all students have received their diploma, and that you stay seated during the ceremony. Pictures will be taken and proofs will be sent to each of you. Mrs. Feliciana Moreno, Mrs. Catherine Schnetsky, and Mrs. Angelica Valdivia, our counselors, will be reading the names of the graduating seniors in their respective academies. Students, please approach the platform.
Catherine Sysik.
We're not supposed to count.
Why not?
Tony Petroff. Elizabeth Hanstead. Coleman Doring. Kiara Davis. Matthew Dwyer. Maze Kauf. Emma Jacobson. Gabriella Berthium.
Oh, they're supposed to put their tassel to the left.
Lene Smith Morris.
Oh.
Sarika Rickert. Maria Paulino Ramirez.
What?
Gino Stacy. Aaliyah Muchka. Dylan Zimmerman. Torin Walton. David Steffen. Adriana Avila. Riley Glover. Ella Simbalnik. Lauren Hanser. Cassandra Vassar. Melvin Davis.
All right, Mel. Okay, Mel.
Jaden Scannendor.
I guess you can say something.
Say something.
Not embarrassing.
Stephen Hall.
He wanted to be embarrassing.
No, don't.
Romeo
about Martinez. 300 people for him. Didn't they just say don't say nothing?
Mariana Frederick. Maria Cabrera Cordoba. Aria Goodall. Ciandre Mango. Josue Garcia. Seth Jarstead. Mario Clayton. Matthew Gangle. Jose Soto. Alyssa Cifuentes. Daniel Hay. Autumn Beck. Mikhail Smith. Jasmine Gomez.
The drone.
Emmanuel Brown. Anthony Bueno.
I guess we can say something.
Kayla Toe.
Are you going to scream for Autumn and Haley? Me too. Is she coming out? No.
Emma Latis. Niavani Shannon. Maggie Ortel. Joshua Bell.
Mm-mm.
Angela Farrell. Daquan Jordan. Tamazian Say. Maurice Brown. Amaya Arndt. Tiana Garrett. Jawan Harris. Joe Prudham. Alexander Settler. Alexander Ross. Connor Martin. Dakota Poquette. Carly Edwards.
Oh, there's Carly.
Joe Lynch. Logan Ray.
Sit her down.
Tyler Stanky. Romeo Rodriguez. Tavian Hart.
Just call to get in the picture.
Travion Lester. Devin Vasquez. Ryan Irby.
Adam Snegson.
Marshawn Hudson.
Haley's gonna come out. Oh.
Michael Jackson.
Oh, Michael!
Oh.
Giorgio Ramos. Logan Valen.
Is that Logan? Your friend?
No, it's not. It's not
Damian Vergas. Elijah Wilson.
Yeah. Adams Lenise going up there.
Arellano.
That's Adams. Io. The sixth one on the end.
Shakira Johnson. Kovin Miknovich. Benjamin Hayden. Devin Dreshny.
Mikey! You did that, boy! You did that!
Dylan Zickis.
Mikey!
Nathan Fortier.
Did that, boy!
Jeremy Lackey.
Jeremy!
Ronnie Davis. Trey Smith. Destiny Moorhead. Kara Wells. Haley Lehman. Lillian Sobieski.
I almost got you there.
Christian Arredondo.
He's still at the end.
Riley Howell. Michaela M. Zumara.
Who?
Adrian Richmond.
This way. Right there, straight, directly.
Layla New.
It's the front one. You see Adam up there?
And this Daniel aisle, sir. De La Rosa.
I can't see him.
This aisle is kind of...
When coming up?
A long time.
Logan Horner.
Is that Logan? No.
Yeah, it's Logan.
Okay.
Aaliyah Jackson.
Okay now, Aaliyah.
Vibrato Solano. Riley Dustman.
I'm still looking for my boy. Done lost him again.
Ayana Marisol Crespo. Contrell Safel. Jemiah Ponder. Jonathan Soto. Candace Lopez. Gabriela Rios. Emily Shinkowicz. Bianca Ramirez.
Adam's over there. Straight like that.
Sitlali Cruz.
I think he's going to be short one.
Yeah. My baby, he took after his mama.
Destiny Davis.
He's my short one, but that's all right. He's doing good.
Tavasia Harris.
Aaliyah!
Imari Jackson. Kaylee Lopez. Austin Nelson. Autumn Heidi. Ben Casper. Michael Monday.